these days, social networking sites like Facebook are as part of teenagers' lives as homework and Friday night football. But the sites leave users open to predators, fraud, identity theft, and bullying. To help educate students, administrators at one middle school here in Maine set up an experiment designed to see if students knew who their Facebook friends really were. News 8's Aaron O'Valley is here with a closer look.
Several teachers and a resource officer from Scarborough Middle School came up with a little experiment, and they say they were shocked at the results. But it proved to be an important lesson and one that they wouldn't learn from any textbook.
Eighth grader Matt Jadaro says that it's an unspoken competition between classmates who can get the most friends on Facebook.
I wanted to get 900, so I got 900.
As he got closer to his goal of 1,000 friends, he began accepting requests from people he admits that he really didn't know. Both Maddie and Mike were on that list of strangers.
I didn't really look where he was from because I thought he was from Bonnie Eagle, and he played football for them, so I kind of just added him because of that.
Little did Matt and many other classmates know, computer teacher Paula Doe and resource officer Rob Pellerin were actually the people behind these two profiles.
We created the accounts. We wanted to kind of test the waters to see if we put a little bit of information on there, how many students would actually accept our friend request.
They sent out 400 friend requests, and within just 2 weeks, the fictitious friend Mike had more than 325 friends. It only took Maddie a week to collect more than 150.
We could see all of their information, all of their photos, all of their videos.
Before revealing their true identity, they asked their students this.
Do you know everybody on your friend list? Do you personally know everybody on your friend list? And they all said yes. And so it was quite shocking to them when they realized that Mike and Maddie were fictitious characters.
I was kind of shocked. I was really shocked.
Matt admits he learned a valuable lesson.
I learned a lot of stuff, why I shouldn't add everybody. I don't want people looking at my Facebook that I don't know.
Officer Pellerin says if your child has a Facebook account, there are many privacy settings that you can take advantage of. I'm going to go on my Facebook page to show you. First, go up to the upper right-hand corner under Account, scroll down to Privacy Settings, and you'll see that it automatically defaults to Custom Settings, which means that everyone can see your photos and your bio. So make sure to click on Friends Only. And under your birthday information, be sure you don't include the year you were born. That's to avoid identity theft. Also, under Photos and Videos, you can decide who can and cannot see your pictures. You can also block people from tagging you in their photos. And finally, be sure to protect your contact information. That includes your email, your phone number, and your address. After deleting that or blocking it, make sure to click Preview My Profile to save it.
There are thousands of predators out there, even millions, and they're not out there to reconnect with old friends. A lot of these predators are out there for one purpose, and that's to victimize people and kids.
After this experiment, the teachers held an after-school Facebook makeover event to help their students and parents customize their pages. Matt and his mom, Terry, attended the event and deleted over 350 friends from his page. Matt says he understands why, but hopes to someday get his numbers back up again.
I will get 1,000 friends. I will. I will.
And you'll know all of them, right?
Yeah, sure.
If your child does have a Facebook account, Officer Pellerin says that parents must have one too. It is very important to monitor what they are posting and who they are accepting. In the studio, Aaron O'Valley, News 8.